And welcome back to part two of Shadows and Diamonds by Elisha Blake. It's your boy Drew Blue. Anyways, we're gonna pick up where we last left off. We covered the first five tracks on part number one. Now part number two for this episode is gonna be the next set of five, hopefully, that I can knock out before the video comes to an end. We're gonna start with track number six, and this one is titled Uno, my bad. This song is worth dancing to. Golly. That's a freaking good ass hit. That's what I'm gonna say, man. Wow. You're the only one. Killed that shit. In a bad way. But I like the way he came through with that song, you know? You're the only one. And man, that 808. Just coming in, like, it goes doom, and then that's it, and then it just leaves you guessing, like, when it's gonna drop again. I love it. I freaking love it. Okay. My apologies. I was just looking at this, so, okay. apologies, y'all. I got distracted real quick. I was just looking at some important mail. But ain't no time for that. This song was definitely bumping. It was hot. It was definitely a all-around great, good feel track. I mean, I'm not a dancer, but you saw me. I was definitely feeling it right there. Like, the melody was just cruising through. This is a vintage Elijah Blake song because he just comes out at you, and you really don't feel that. And especially how they did that twist at the end. My God, that song came in hard, and it just was everywhere. Like, you couldn't tell where the song was going to lead to. Like, I thought it was going to keep dropping, and he just slowed it down tempo-wise right there at the last 30 or 40 seconds. Man, clean as song. So, yeah, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling the vibe. Definitely, like, I love Uno, man. You're the only one. Makes sense. You know, Uno, one, you know, Spanish. You know, it gets together. It's that lingo. Yeah, but with that being said, though, I'm going to go ahead and grab me some grub real quick, and then we will pick up on track number 7. But before I do, go ahead and pause. Let me see if I can come up with one little things or, like, last minute, last second feedback. I believe he released this as a single. In fact, all the songs that really are bumping on here, like I Just Wanna, Uno, I believe those songs were his singles that he did release beforehand, you know, for the upcoming release of this album at the time. And if that's the case, Uno should have been bumping in a Billboard, you know, top 100. I don't understand how. Maybe I gotta double check those numbers, but yeah, this song has to be in the top 10, or otherwise that's, you know, ludicrous, man. You know, no call outs to, you know, Chris Bridges, but man, I was feeling that song. That's a groovy ass song. I'll be right back, y'all. Welcome back, y'all. I'm just gonna do a little quick promotion. Not getting paid for this. This is brought to you by Chemo. I'm just playing with y'all. If anyone's looking to get, like, a really good deal on, like, power tools, if you like to do things on your own, you know, you do a lot of, like, DIY projects, especially if you're working on your car at home, and you like to see something that's pretty good on Amazon, so that way you don't have to get up your butt and go to, like, Lowe's or Home Depot to pick up some equipment, this will be delivered right to your door, so that way you can just pretty much go in with some robe and pick up whatever you need to get. But, like, Chemo, really good company. I got their electric ratchet tool set, and it comes with like 6 sockets, 2 batteries like this, and a charger. I got it for like a lightning deal, but essentially you get it for like under 80 bucks. I mean, not bad compared to like the top brand like Milwaukee, where you only get the tool itself for over 100, man. So you'd be saving a lot of money that way. Torque's up to 30 foot-pounds. Hey, I got a lot of bolts out. I mean, so like, especially if you got to deal with long bolts in your engine bay or in your car, and like, you don't want to spend forever just using a regular ratchet trying to get it out. You know, obviously electric ratchet is the way to go. I got it in my back of my trunk somewhere over there. I'm just too lazy to get up and show it to y'all, but check it out though. I just got the new drill. So badass. I love it. But that's enough of a free promotion there. They didn't authorize this. I just wanted to promote it because I think it's a great product. So I'm not sponsored or anything like that. But just want to give a little cosign to y'all. Appreciate that, Chemo. But yeah, so I just want to really say that, real, you know, just to recap, the last song, Uno, is a damn good song. I love it. I enjoyed it. It was fun dancing to it. And yeah, it would be one of those songs where, you know what, I can't contain it. Like, even if I was really, like, in a very stressed mood, I play that song, I might actually being a little bright-minded there, so I apologize for that, but that song jumped out of nowhere. So yeah, enough about track number 6. Let's get to track number 7. This one is titled, it's either pronounced Pinot or Peanut, but it is spelled P-I-N-O-T, so feel free to pronounce it however you would like. But anyways, track number 7, let's get it. Love that guitar too, it's clean.
Check the doctor, please. think of this late at night. And I'm not trying to start a fight, but I hate the way we ended and the fact you got me cheating. I hate these new beginnings even though I am the reason. The only thing I love right now is you. Going through my phone and calling up the numbers you don't know that make up sex even when it's wrong. Our love was that strong. I'm just tripping off that crazy hope. It sucks to see that you don't fill me up. Blow me a glass and let my feelings flow. Count all this message ain't subliminal.
Second verse goes even deeper, talking about, you know, his lady's parents, and about how, like, her mama's a breadwinner, and her dad just doesn't like him at all, which would be understandable if he knows that he cheated on her. But he goes in a little deeper about how, like, you know, all these years of them being together, you think you could learn something from them. So, like, he really is going into deep about it, you know, like, putting some, you know, thought into it. It just shows to you, you know, like, people can make mistakes, but at the same time, when they really are feeling low because of it and feeling ashamed, you really can see things a lot more clear, you know. And it sucks like that, but eventually some people really learn from, you know, going through the hard path, and eventually they become better people out of it. So it's necessary, you know, it's a necessary growing pain to go through, I think. And, you know, it's just Elijah Blake really lamenting that all in the lyrics and just singing it in a beautiful melodic way with this phenomenal instrumental and that guitar. Wow. Really got me just feeling that shit deep in the soul. And I'm not gonna lie, kind of really wish Nico Lafrey would have been on the feature in this. I wish I could hear Nico on that. He would definitely spat some good bars. Maybe something about Demisha, just to compliment Elijah Blake. But yeah, I love the fact that, you know, he killed it on that guitar lead instrumental, man. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave it at that. Peanut is a damn good track. I'm really surprised. I'm liking this album a lot more than I really did when I first played it. Wow, this is really a golden loot just hidden within my thousands of albums in my phone, man. I'm really surprised I don't listen to this as much as I should. But yeah, really underrated track and an underrated score here. So let's go ahead and hit the next track, track number 8, and this one's titled Live Till We Die. Let's get it. Okay. Some reggae dancehall. Taking it back home. Man, clean. Woo! Yo! Whoa! Oh, man. I gotta calm down the fuck bit. Yo, look. This is what I'm talking about when Elijah Blake just is spontaneous. You don't know what he's gonna hit you with. I want you to know, like, the people I listen to on a regular basis are the people who are the most spontaneous, the most creative, like, who I consider true artists in the game. Elijah Blake is one of them, all right? The other guys I just covered previously are the same way. Nicola Frey, in his own way, is a creative artist. Johnny Rain, second series I covered before this, creative as hell. Really is like the yin to Elijah Blake's yang, if you think about it. Or you can flip it the other way around. I'm sorry. He's the yang, the dark side to Elijah Blake's yin, the light white side. You know what I mean? Like, it don't matter. You know, Elijah Blake makes tracks that are more lighthearted and more bumpy. And then Johnny Rain's more about deep inside, which is why he works so well with Johnny Rain. But like, I want y'all to understand why I have it, the series going this way, because I want y'all to catch some kind of vibes. Like, these are the artists I listen to on a regular basis. Spontaneous. Comes out of nowhere. I mean, shoot, I'm listening to this beat, and at first, okay, I'm thinking he's gonna hit us with some dancehall, some reggae type of vibe, because, you know, he's Caribbean, you know, so, like, I'm like, okay, I'm feeling it, and then, boom, comes out of nowhere with that transition, and then next thing you know, you get this electric dance step, dubstep coming in. I mean, wow, like, just tossing in, like, everything, like, as if he was making what they call it, like, gumbo, like, down in New Orleans, you know, like, tossing everything in, except it's not all that bunch of meat stuff stew. It's like almost like splattering all kinds of paint, and you get all that disco shit, and it's just like glitter and all that, like, woo, spectacular. Like, damn, love that track, dope, woo. And y'all just wait until we get to the next series, the next artist I'm covering. In my opinion, he's gonna be the greatest artist in the world. He will peak to that point, but right now he's going through some lows, in my opinion, in his career. This is the lowest point of his career. But enough foreshadowing. Y'all will know when I cover him, and I'll announce it as I wrap up, you know, series 3 review for Elijah Blake. But right now, let's enjoy Elijah Blake right now, and in this bumping in this thing. Damn. Live till we die. That's what I'm talking about. That really, really stands out. Like, I love it when a song really complements the title that it's given to. You know, Live Till We Die. This is about just going out and having fun until, you know, you 6 feet under. But freak it. While you're still alive, go out there and be a freak and live life happy. I'm going to tell this to anyone. I don't give a damn. Be who you are. I don't care if it's meaning that you got to be a fool. Hell, I'll say I'm a fool at times. I don't give a damn. Better to live life as a fool than not to live life at all. Because then if you're not being yourself, you're not really living. So that's what I'm saying. F all the critics. You know what I mean? I'm going to try to keep it as clean as possible, because you never know where I'll be in 10 years. Who knows? I could be quarterbacking the New York Football Giants, but I'm not going to get there. Anyways, Live Till We Die, track number 8. Dope. I'm loving it. Give me 1 second. I got to put something in storage. Then after that, wrap it all up, do the last 2 tracks, and then that's it for part 2. But give me 1 second, y'all. Boop, 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 boop. And we are back, man. So I'm still shaking from track number 8, man. Wow. I like that guy's storage room. Damn, I like that. I'm going to set up like that one day in the future. It's going to be like a tool shop. But no, what the fuck is this Bill Belichick looking dude walking around here for me? Look at that, I swear, he got the hoodie, he got the headset on, like he's about to call the game. Shoot, I'll be the quarterback, let's go. Ah! Oh, man. I love track number 8. Elijah Blake, you really are one of my favorite artists, man. I'm just going to tell you that right now. Like, God, this album is so freaking good. I can't believe I slept on this for years, man. Years. Shame on me. And, like, I'm not joking with y'all. Like, the first time I heard it, I was on a road trip from Phoenix to Vegas. No, I was trying to go back from Phoenix to Vegas. And, like, it was my first time going back. So, like, getting used to the roads, I wasn't really paying attention No, actually, my apologies. The first time I went on a solo trip to Phoenix, it's the first time I ever left the city of Vegas on my own. And man, like, I was just so distracted with everything. Like, I didn't really get a chance to absorb the song the way I should have absorbed the song, or like this album, I mean. But yeah, I love it. 8 tracks in, and this is a phenomenal piece of artwork, you know, like masterpiece by Elijah Blake. So, Sir Elijah Blake, hey, thank you for blessing us with that beautiful music. I'm gonna go ahead and keep going, letting this vibe go on with track number 9. And this one's titled, About That Life. Let's get it, baby. Woo!
Tell me what's the kingdom, beside my queen.
Amen.
Rule by my side, my side, baby. Didn't I love you and make you weak?
That ate away. That's really Elijah Blake just tackling some West Coast sounds onto it, you know, onto a beat. And man, it's dope. I love that song. Look, if you ain't about that life, you ain't about that life. I think he made that really clear with Every Day on track number 2. But just elaborating it in such a finesse way. Damn. With such finesse, man. Clean. And you know, that West Coast vibe was dope. I mean, I'm not going to lie. Like, it wouldn't kill anybody to get a Nipsey Hussle verse on this, or Dom Kennedy. I mean, especially when they were still working up on it, I think that would have been a perfect time for them to connect, since it really was, you know, kind of like trending in a similar fashion. But my point is, dope song. The West Coast vibe here really is strong. I'm not really too sure how it is. I know that Elijah Blake is Caribbean descent. I think he might have lived in LA for a while, or if he's just based in LA, just making his music coming up in here. I'm not too sure. For me, I mean, I'm just gonna say straight up, like, I look at Elijah Blake as an LA artist. Like, you know, this is who he, or like the city where he's really kind of like represented now. But I could be wrong. Who knows? I've always had that image, anyways. Like, he was just like in the same group as Johnny Rain, Elijah Blake. I mean, not Elijah Blake, Eric Bellinger, you know what I mean? It was just, I don't know where he grew up, what part of the city, but all I know is that it's nice to hear that West Coast vibe coming in here. Like I said, I could get a Nipsey Hussle, Dom Kennedy verse, just a little rap verse to complement this song. I mean, it's 3 minutes and 15 seconds, so you could fit a 40-second verse on that and consider it a rap, you know what I mean? But... no, definitely, I love that song, About That Life. The vibe was clean. That 808 was just nasty. And I mean that in a good way. You know what I mean? Like those old-fashioned 90s, like fat 808s, when before they would bang and vibrate, the whole speaker sound, you know, it was just kind of like clean and, you know, just like, kind of like that. But and then the synths from the background reverb, oh man. Phenomenal production on it is what I'm trying to get to y'all. So hopefully you guys could translate all that. But this was a phenomenal performance by Elijah Blake. Came in, really cleaned it. I mean, it's just like adding some frosting, some really nice decorations to a really well-baked cake. So, you know, if Elijah Blake's the baker, hey, I'm eating that cake, man. You know what I mean? Don't take it the wrong way. But either way, though, yeah, it's a damn good song. That's all I can tell you. Let me get to the last track, and then after that I will wrap up part number two, and then eventually I'll get to the last four for part three. It might be dark by the time I hit that track, so at least you guys might get some more light action. So definitely, like, if you can't tell now, like, the lights are shining bright, so be on the lookout for that. When I do part three, it'll be nighttime. But anyways, track number 10, and then that's it for part two. It is titled Drop Dead Beautiful. Let's get it.
Drop
Girls, or that we have the same ex?
I don't know. Let's not think about it.
Wait, did you hear something?
I don't know. Did you order a pizza or something?
Did you see me order a fucking pizza? You know why I order no goddamn pizza? Shit. Oh my god, I think this nigga just pulled up on us.
What?
Oh my god, he just pulled up on us. Oh my god.
Wow.
Bitch, don't act like we both don't know this nigga's crazy. Fucking Gemini, man. I should have listened to my zodiac. Crazy ass.
Don't you mean horoscope?
No. I said what I said. It's the zodiac. Now get down before you see yours.
Okay.
So, this is kind of one of those moments where, like, you kind of walk in and just be like, question mark right on top of your head. Like, what the? Like, give me that Nick Young meme face. Like, I can't do it like how he does. Like, but either way, though, like, I'm trying too hard. That's why. But, like, you know, it's just like, what? So, the two questions that they asked was like, is it weirder that we both are girls or we have the same names? Now that can only tell you one thing. She went left. Yep. Yikes. No, just kidding. You know how like Kendrick Lamar went, like instead of making that right turn, she went left. She went, well, I think he was like, she went dyke or something like that. Tammy song. Essentially, that's the thing that what happened right here. So, you know, I think the girl, this Chanel, thought Elijah Blake probably was fooling around with a bunch of girls from different states and decided to hook up with one of them and find out, maybe, who knows? Maybe he was playing both of them. Who knows? I don't know.